Hello world, my name is James Daly and I'm a senior escalation engineer on the Windows Store App Developer Solutions team. In this blog, I'm going to show you some of the cool features in Visual Studio that you can use to preview, edit, and import your game, image, and mesh assets. Most people aren't aware of these powerful features that really make writing games for Windows Phone 8 quick and easy. Visual Studio can automatically convert your asset files into the file format that works best with DirectX. The built-in conversion utility automatically converts images, 3D models, as well as some shader files. This conversion happens automatically at compile time via a content task. Here are some examples of the common mesh and image file formats that Visual Studio can automatically convert for you. These formats include some of the most popular and common asset file formats for game developers. Virtually every 3D asset creation application on the market can export in one of these common formats. Let's take a look how it works. First, let's take a look at Visual Studio's Asset Editor tool. We'll get started by importing a 3D model of a jet fighter that I downloaded for free from one of my favorite stock 3D model repository sites. To preview the model, all we need to do is go to File, Open, and File. Then we'll browse to the location of our 3D model and choose the appropriate format. In this case, let's go ahead and choose the Collada DAE format. Click Open. As you can see, the model is now open in Visual Studio's 3D editor. We can move around the model to get a look at it from different angles. But we can do more than just view the model. We can manipulate and modify the model. I really want this model to stick out in my game, so let's change the color of the jet's body from this drab gray color to something a little bit more exciting. Let's say, red. We can do this by selecting the jet's body in the viewer. Then we can change the diffuse properties of the model's material by modifying the red, blue, and green values in the property editor. Now we have a super fast looking jet fighter without needing to open up a complex 3D program. Visual Studio's 3D editor is perfect for quick, on-the-spot tweaks and changes to your 3D models. Next, let's take a look at adding a 3D asset to a project and have Visual Studio automatically convert the asset to a more DirectX-friendly format. To demonstrate this, I've taken a simple sample from the DirectX toolkit and modified it to be even simpler. I'll make the stripped-down sample available to you so you can follow along at home. Let's see how this works. I have the sample open in Visual Studio 2013 Ultimate. We add the 3D model to our project just like any other asset. We right-click on the Assets folder, choose Add, and then Existing Item. Let's use the same DAE format and jet fighter that we used previously once again. Now we need to tell Visual Studio that we want it to convert our mesh assets for us. To do this, we need to customize our build steps. We can right-click on the project name in the Solutions Explorer and then choose Build Dependencies and then Build Customizations. Now we want to select Mesh Content Task. If we have bitmaps that we want to use as textures, we may also want to choose Image Content Task. Now we need to tell Visual Studio that the model we just added to our assets needs to be converted and copied to our AppX directory. We can do that by right-clicking on our asset and going to Properties. Next, change the item type to Mesh Content Pipeline. We also need to set the content field to Yes and the Exclude from Build to No. Now our model will be automatically converted and added to our AppX package. All we need to do now is load our mesh into our DirectX toolkit code. Let's do that by opening up the DirectX TK3D scenerender.cpp file. I've set a bookmark in the Create Device Dependent Resources function. Now all we need to do is modify our mesh loading code by specifying the name of our model. Remember that the model has been converted from the DAE format to the DirectX-friendly CMO format, so we need to take that into account when we specify the file name. Let's run the app and see what we get. And there we go. We now have our jet fighter spinning helplessly in 3D space. I hope this video blog was helpful. We took a look at two incredibly powerful and often overlooked features of Visual Studio 2013 that can really help make DirectX game programming quick and easy. Well, until next time, we'll be seeing you.